Hi, I'm Lucy Ravitch at kidsmathteacher.com, where we're turning everyday experiences into hands-on math activities.
Yay!
Welcome to today's Math Activity Thursday. Today we're going to be working with apples. You might be wondering, how can you turn eating apples into a hands-on math activity? One of the first things you do with your apples is weigh them. If you don't have one of these make great fun in the kitchen. Take the measurements of different apples, compare the different weights, maybe even go into how much things cost at the grocery store. If you have to pay a dollar per pound, how much would you have to pay for the apples that you have at home? Usually the measurements you can weigh with your kitchen scale are ounces, pounds, grams, or kilograms. This is a great tool for the kitchen because kids love to measure how much they're going to eat and different weights of things. And you'll find that as you talk about different weights of things, it's really a lot of math. While you're doing this math activity Thursday, you might decide to use the measurements and make a chart. Making charts are great ideas for showing your kids how math works, and also it deals a lot with science. So once you've weighed your apples, seen how much you want to compare with your apples, it's time to start slicing them. As you slice them, you can talk about how many sections you're cutting it into, trying to make them as equal as possible. As you cut them, you can talk about fractions. Fractions are something that sometimes people get scared of, but they're really easy. You talk to them about the one whole apple being cut into two parts. The denominator is always the parts. So if you cut it in two, it's one half. Of course, you guys probably know that. If it comes in four, it's each 1/4, and 1/8, 1/12 if you want to go that far. Cut them how you'd like to do them, and then compare. You can even use the weight again to see how you like to cut your apples. Once you've cut your apples, you might want to make some sort of chart, seeing the different fractions that could make a whole, and also seeing equivalent fractions. The key to having fun with math is just to make it fun and integrate it into your regular activities, and talk about math words as you go about your day. So when you're cutting these apples, you'll use halves, quarters, sections, parts. All of these have to do with math and with fractions. After you've cut your apple, we're going to make designs with them. Making designs with them is an optional thing you can do, but as you have fun with your apples and make designs with them, you can see lines of symmetry. You can talk about how many parts are you using. Maybe you decide to use only two pieces of apple to make a design. But most of the time, the more parts you include, the more interesting your designs can be. I can't wait to see what designs you come up with. Now it's time for the fun part, eating your apples. As you eat your apples, it's a great time to talk about subtraction. Subtraction with the parts or with the whole. Whatever your kids are ready for, you can talk to them about it. It can expand their minds. So if you just did counting of the pieces, then you'll want to do subtraction of the individual pieces. But if you did fractions, you'll want to talk about taking away certain fractions. Thanks for watching, and I hope you'll have a great time with your apples. Let me know in the comments below what you did and how you had fun with your apples. Maybe you did something else with your apples. I want to know. If you like this video, I'd love you to subscribe and join me next week as I do every Math Activity Thursday. I'll also be doing some product reviews for fun hands-on math activities, as well as just products that you might use in your home or in your classroom. Make sure you check out kidsmathteacher.com for some fun activities for you and your kids.